This video was made possible through the support of my patrons. Something's missing. Post has arrived. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS, and today's the day. It has finally arrived after a couple of weeks' delay, a random one. It seems like almost all of these have had some sort of delay. This has arrived. I don't even know why I cut that bit. It seems like I can just safely open this up. I've brought this for insurance because today we're going to be unboxing the Doctor Who Season 8 Blu-ray collection. So I'm seeing this as usual for the first time with all of you wonderful folks. So you can see it there, beautiful. Here we go. Yes, Doctor Who Season 8 collection, starring the wonderful Jon Pertwee. This is the series that broadcast around 1971. This was Jon Pertwee's second season. This is also the 50th anniversary of this season. Ergo, the 50th anniversary of the Master's first appearance, played by Roger Delgado in Terror of the Autons. All 25 episodes, newly remastered and packed with bonus material. But let's have a wonderful look at this. Now, I actually am not that well acquainted with this season. I watched Terror of the Autons and maybe one or two episodes of The Daemons. Someone's going to correct me that in the comment section below. I remember this being a season that played quite a lot on UK TV Gold, like in the late noughties. That was kind of when I watched a few of these episodes here. I watched Terror of the Autons, but the other ones I don't really know much about. I haven't watched Claws of Axos, Colony in Space, Mind of Evil. Like I said, I've only watched maybe one episode of The Daemons, and I've watched Terror of the Autons because it's the Auton story, so you have to watch that one. So this is a season that I'm really actually looking forward to watching from beginning to end. I'll try and do another ranking video in the near future like I did with season 14, because it'll be interesting to, you know, see if these stories hold the test of time and guess which is the best one of this season. However, one thing I do like here is that we actually do have Roger Delgado and Nicholas Courtney, both of whom are featured in this starring segment. My feedback has finally been taken on board. For long-time viewers of these unboxing videos, you'll notice that I think it's the Brigadier or it's either the Master, it's one or the other, just didn't wind up being in the starring segment. I'm going to actually look at my bookshelf and find out. Okay, I've just double checked. It was Nicholas Courtney who got credits, although he didn't get one in the season 26 Blu-ray. But yeah, Anthony Ainley didn't get credited. Roger Delgado does, although I think that's because he appears in every single story here. And Nicholas Courtney, with this being still Earthbound set with UNIT, it was basically just a member of the supporting cast. You've also got Richard Franklin and John Levine there. So, brand new special features, updated special effects for Terror of the Autons. That's the one with the pretty infamous green screen. I think I'm just going to watch the original version because it has its charm. In conversation, Matthew Sweet's chats with actor Katie Manning. Behind the sofa, Terrence and me with Frank Skinner. The direct route, immersive 5.1 surround sound. The Daemons Omnibus, a 90-minute movie edit. The Vampire from Space, a new extended edit of the opening episode of The Claws of Axos. Archive treats, Blu-ray trailer PDF material, including all of the stuff that was on the original Blu-ray releases of these stories. So that lamp is a little bit annoying. Let's get rid of this plastic sheen. Make sure scalpers can never get their hands on this box set. So yeah, beautiful stuff. This is just incredible artwork, as usual, by the incomparable Lee Binding. Incredible stuff. I want to know, because I think I've asked this before, but people don't tend to tell me in the comment section, do you throw these away? I keep these. You saw my shelf earlier on. I do keep these. I want to know, do you keep a hold of them? Do you throw them in the bin, mate? Please let me know. So we've got artwork of Jon Pertwee holding the dematerialization circuits. We've got Roger Delgado as the Master. We've got the Autons. We've got the things from Claws of Axos. We've got the Daemon. We've got that Gavin. We've got Gavin there. And on the back, we of course have the wonderful TARDIS artwork. correct me if I'm wrong, like I said, I've not seen these stories. Is Colony in Space like the only story of like this season that takes place off Earth? I'm going to presume that the TARDIS travelling might be a screenshot from that. But, you know, like I said, I'm not that well acquainted with this season. But let's fix that. Let's open this thing up. Now, I have seen a couple of people mention their discs have turned up broken. So if that is the case, you can get in touch with BBC Worldwide to get these things amended. So I'm just going to double check that these discs didn't break in transit. Okay, they all seem fine. And by when I mean broken, I don't mean that they're just like little chipped or that they've got scratches, as in brokered. Also, apparently, one or two people have said that the booklet inside here has got a few pages missing. We'll learn together if that's the case, but if that is the case with your collection, please double check. So, we've got the Third Doctor and Joe Grant here. I'm assuming this is the Colony in Space, like I said. Don't know. I'm going into this relatively blind. I do know this, though. This is the this is Terror of the Auton stuff. This is a mask. This is Roger Delgado in the background. And as usual, we've got on the inside here the Doctor's respective TARDIS for that season. So we'll just put this down and take a look at what we've got in here. So we do have a booklet. If I do have some pages missing from this main one, I think they might have made up for it by just giving me extra pages. You know, as usual stuff. Worlds Apart, Dalek Awakens, Escape Room, Time Lord Victorious, Games, etc. Maybe we'll get rid of that. So with this one, like I said, the artwork, we know this is Terror of the Autons. Beautiful stuff. Oh, that's really nice. We've got a Katie Manning signature and a Roger Delgado signature at the back. Normally it's the Doctor of the season, but you know, John Pertwee has already had a collection. So I think, you know, that's quite fitting. I think that works out really well. That's really nice. So in this book, what we got? At the end of the 1960s, there was a distinct possibility that Doctor Who was on its last legs. Six seasons in, with Patrick Troughton planning his exit and audience figures dwindling, the BBC considered various replacement programmes before granting the Time Lord a last-minute reprieve. Yes, if you watch, I'll give him a plug here, Adam Martin from AMTV. He's done a really good series about Doctor Who viewing figures from the classic era. And if you watch that series, you'll understand how in the late 60s, early 70s, Doctor Who was possibly about to become a dead property. William Hartnell was not a fan of Doctor Who continuing into the colour era. William Hartnell, basically the first and not my Doctor. But it's great how the incredible work of Barry Letts and Terence Dix was able to revitalise the series, give it a Quatermass feel, a new lease on life by making it Earthbound with John Pertwee. And they were able to save it. So the series is back in business after season 7. Terror of the Autons. There's a lot of stuff here. There's a lot of written material. The Mind of Evil. Colony in Space. On an alien planet. Yes, this is okay. This is the one where they somehow go off world. Like I said, I'd need to have a little refresh, of course. Colony in Space again. I've got two Colonies in Space. I've got 20... Oh, mine does have stuff missing. 12... 21. I do need to get in touch with BBC Worldwide about this. I do have pages missing from this booklet. 24 to 21. Yes, I need to get in touch with BBC Worldwide. I didn't expect that to happen in this unboxing. This is okay, I'm going to drop the pretense. Unboxing's gone wrong. Sketches, fun stuff happens. This genuinely has gone wrong. Okay, so what am I missing? Okay, so we go from the Mind of Evil, another page on the Mind of Evil, then I'm at page... We've gone from page 12 to page 9. So we've repeated... Yeah, we've repeated pages. We've missed out the Claws of Axos entirely. We go straight to Colony in Space. Yeah, this has gone wrong. I need to get in touch with BBC. And then we've got the Daemons, the Demons, the Damons. Whatever that is. Yeah, so 26, 27. And I'm paranoid about the page count now. Ooh, isn't that beautiful? That looks very cool. And then at the end, 9.2 million viewers tuned into episode 1 of The Demons, dropping slightly to 8 million for episode 2, but remaining steady. The compilation of the story on December 28th was a post-Christmas hit watched by 10.5 million viewers. The story is widely regarded as one of the best of the Third Doctor's era. Came 38th in a Doctor Who magazine poll. Terence Dick says, people have said, were you aware that you were making classic television? Of course you're trying to make it good, but the main thing you're trying to do is get it done. Brilliant stuff. And like I said, that's a very nice thing on the end. But yeah, I need to do some chats here. But however, the discs seem to be all in order. Famous last words. So let's take a look. Let's move this book to one side and take a look at the discs.
Okay, so disc one, Terror of the Autons. Disc two, The Mind of Evil. Disc three, Claws of Axos. Disc four, Colony in Space. Disc five, More Colony in Space. And there's our mate Gavin. Disc six, The Daemons. It's again a bit hard to reach these back ones. There's so much plastic in the way. And disc seven, The Daemons. And if we go to the very end, disc eight will be bonus material with, as usual, John Pertwee's smiling face back there as well. So yeah, very consistent in terms of how the box sets look, how they're presented, how they come together, and of course how they look on a shelf as well. So yeah, this looks really cool. This is a set that, you know, I'm not exactly leaps and bounds super happy about. Obviously, I'm happy that they're all getting a great treatment and that it seems like they are not cutting corners for any season. They are giving it like a wholehearted presentation commitment, and that, you know, if you're going to do it with one, you've got to do it with all of them, and I do respect that. But like I said, this is a season I'm not particularly antiquated with. I'm not the biggest John Pertwee fan. I like him as a Doctor, but he's very much like he's playing himself, and his version of the Doctor, while it absolutely has its charm, John Pertwee is a great actor, he's not one that I particularly resonate with personally, but I obviously understand the value, understand the appeal, and he does have some cracking stories in his tenure, and it's a really important and influential tenure as well. Without John Pertwee, without the creative team, the Doctor Who would not have made it out of the 1960s. So, you know, we hold a massive debt of gratitude there for that.
But yeah, very happy with this. Obviously, the booklet, I need to sort that out. I need to get in touch with BBC Worldwide. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on the shelf and I'm going to compare it to all of the other collection box sets. So come join me by the Blu-ray shelf.
Where did season 10 go?
There's only one possible explanation. Isn't that right, Winnie? Come here. Let's try and figure out this mystery together. Is this going to be some sort of weird, strange existential crisis like last time? Some weird supernatural crisis of faith? I'm sure this is going to be a very long and fruitful series of adventures, won't it, Winnie? That can't start right now because I can't safely film with other people. So we're just gonna hold off on that for a little bit. Hey folks, thanks so much for watching this unboxing video. This is basically season 2 of Unboxing Gone Wrong. Like I said at the end of the video, I kind of had to stave off the actual beginning of it because I can't properly film outside and stuff, but do stick around, it should be a fun adventure. So be sure to keep updated on all of my goings on YouTube by hitting that subscribe button. Hitting that like button also really, really helps me out. And also helping me out are my patrons who help to keep the lights on here at Mr. TARDIS. So I'd like to give a particular shout out to these patrons: Anne Neubauer, Matthew Perry, James Raby, Dean Jones, Andrew Blewett, Callum Baird, Daniel Davis, Dylan Whittaker, Flabu, Joseph Adams, Katie Maxwell, Luna Day, Palex, Raven Woods, Rebecca Hill, Shazeb Mangi, The Brit Sniper, Zachary Taylor, aka Mario Fanboy 15, Dan Morrison, Darius, Nathaniel Holden, Samuel Brooks, and Zabi555. Thanks so much to all of my patrons. If you'd like to help to contribute towards my videos and also get some perks and rewards, please consider becoming a patron. All info in the description below. And I'll see you folks next time.